So now we're on to part three. What's bugging you? Yeah, even though you have plants inside your home, you can have many problems, and insects could just be one of them. Probably the number one problem, the most common mistake, and I've mentioned it a few times, is this guy right here. The most common mistake when it comes to growing plants indoors is overwatering, killing with kindness, we call it. Because often when somebody sees a problem, a yellow leaf, a drooping leaf, they think it needs more water. But inside our homes, generally plants are more wet than what they are dry. So before you water, I need to stress, check to make sure that they're dry. Because if not, you're gonna drown them out, which is called root rot. Plants can show you a lot by their leaves. Here's a sansevieria. I told you it's a tough plant. And you're saying to yourself, well, why is that leaf right there dead? This is actually an indication and sign of cold. So when you purchase your plant, and it doesn't matter where you purchase it from, it should have a covering over the top, especially during the winter months. Because if we go outdoors and it's -5, -10, then it can get a bit of cold. That's frost damage. That there is frost damage. And what happens is with the cells inside this plant, there's water, and that water freezes and expands and kills the cell wall and kills the plant. So if you're going to buy plants, try to do it on a milder day. If you do it on a cold day, make sure they have a covering. Never, ever leave them inside your car. Another indication that we can have a problem out there, sorry about that, is that we have a leaf inside our home and we start to see holes. Holes inside your home is a clear indication that you have an insect problem. A lot of the times when they're defined holes like this, it could be slugs and or snails. And that could have come from your pets. And we can use an insecticidal soap like Bug Be Gone to treat these guys to make sure that we can get rid of them. I would remove the leaf overall, do a spraying, and then I would do a spraying within 2 weeks period of time thereafter. So when I look to the leaves on this plant, and this is from a fiddle leaf fig, what I see is I see insect damage on the interior of a leaf. And that is what's called a leaf miner. An insecticidal soap can't actually go through that leaf to get that leaf miner. So what we really have to do for these is remove the leaves off the plant, give a spraying of insecticidal soap, and with that we'll start to remedy that plant overall. Probably the most common insect that you find inside your home is when you put your hand across the top of a plant and you see what appears to be fruit flies. They are not fruit flies. They are fungus gnats. And the key to controlling a fungus gnat, step one, reduce the amount of moisture. So allow those plants to dry out. Step two, any decaying stems or leaves or anything around the base of the plant, remove those, removing habitat from the fungus gnat. Then the third step is if you get yellow sticky traps, and with a yellow sticky trap, you just put it right beside that plant, the fungus gnats will go fly and stick on those sticky traps and you'll reduce the population. So step one, let the plants dry out. Step two, clean them up. Step three, with a little bit of some sticky traps and you'll control your fungus gnats. So the key is always look to your leaves. Look to the problems that are there and the leaves will tell you the story about what's going on with the plant, and insects can happen indoors. And the main thing, and one thing I almost forgot to tell you, if you go and you see that your plant's not really thriving, but it feels like there's sticky substances on the leaves, that's actually an indication of aphids. And those aphids, as they eat, they secrete a waste that's sticky in behind. So if you have sticky leaves, if you have cobwebs, if you have dying leaves, if you have holes in your leaves, if you have any indication of browning leaves, always check your moisture. Second thing is a little spraying with insecticidal soap, and we'll get through this and we'll make sure nothing is bugging you indoors again. So a yellow leaf on a plant, what does it tell you? As soon as you see a yellow leaf, number one, ask yourself, is this plant in the right location? For instance, this Diefenbachia, the reason why this leaf is just yellowed is it's here in the greenhouse and it was left in the middle of a bench in the wide open and it just got too much sun. So if your plant's in the wrong location, that's one reason why a leaf may be yellowing. The second reason why a leaf may be yellowing is just too much moisture. Check the pot. Make sure that it's not overwatered or underwatered. So either too much water or too little water is another indication of a yellowing leaf. And then the third reason for a yellowing leaf with an indoor plant is that a heating vent may be coming on and that heat is changing the temperature and creating a temperature variation that may be causing that problem. And then as we already mentioned as well, or have mentioned in the past, is temperature. If that leaf is touching a glass, piece of glass, like your window, or it just gets too cold, you could have a yellowing leaf. Essentially, yellowing leaves show stress. The key is determine what stress is causing or how that stress is being caused to the plant. You fix it, you move it to a new location, you reduce the watering, or you close that heating vent, and boom, you got a perfect plant.